Welcome to Ramona United Methodist Church on this Christmas Eve. If you are a guest with us or we haven't met yet, I'm Pastor Christy, and I'm so glad that you are here with us this evening. Well, this past week, we had a very special chapel time with our preschool. And thanks to your generosity, we gave each child a book, and they were very excited to receive it during our chapel time together. So thank you so much for supporting our preschool families with this great ministry, and also thank you for supporting the Giving Tree, which we supported and helped two families this year. You really shared the love of Christ with the preschool children and those families this year. Our church office will be closed on Tuesday, December the 26th, but we'll reopen on Thursday. If you have any needs, Margaret will be there to help you. Now, next Sunday is New Year's Eve, so we have a pre-recorded worship service for you on our YouTube channel that is ready to go at 9:45. So we won't have an in-person worship next Sunday at our regular time. But it's also the fifth Sunday of the month. And recently we started a new tradition called a fifth Sunday service, where we serve together in the community on this particular Sunday. Well, the holiday sort of throws off our plans and makes that difficult. But we invite you to do a service project on your own or with your family, if not that day, sometime this week or the week after. We will return to our in-person worship on January the 7th, and it will be Epiphany Sunday and Baptism of the Lord. So we have a lot of neat aspects planned for that service. We'll kick off a six-week sermon series called Revealed, in which we will explore how Jesus was revealed after his birth and how he continues to be revealed to us today. If you know of any teens who would like to take confirmation classes in the early part of the year, please let me know and I can give you more information about that. All right, so for at the end of our service tonight, we will have our traditional candle lighting out on the patio. And the bell choir will ring, not sing, but I guess the choir will sing and the bell choir will ring Silent Night. Now, when we get to that part of the service, I will take the Christ candle and light it here, and then I'll walk down the center aisle, and then I'll invite you to follow me from the back aisles and then just sort of work your way forward in a nice orderly fashion. We'll go out this back door here. There are candles in the corner there, so you can get one of those, and if you prefer a battery-operated candle, we have those as well. So once we go out to the patio there, we will, and our musicians are in place, they will be going out this door, then we will light the candles. So I want, this is very special, so I want everybody to be able to do this the safest way possible. So the safest way to do that is the person who has a lit candle, you hold it upright, and the person who needs to light your candle, you do it sideways. So if you do it the opposite, you get burned. So hold the one with the lit candle, hold it, and then you'll just offer it to your neighbor, and then they will light from your candle. Okay? All right. On this holy night, we meet a great mystery. In the quiet of a stable or a cave, we hear the cry of a newborn child. In the stillness of a field, we see the glory of God. Come and find the mystery of love. Stand as you are able for the call to worship.
To a people longing for hope and yearning for deliverance, the prophet Isaiah declared, The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light had shined. For a child had been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Tonight we come seeking hope, peace, joy, and love, and we find these things in a child. God made flesh as a baby in a manger, a baby who is both the beginning and the end of our salvation, who dwells with us even now, our Emmanuel, God with us.
We live as his people in between, who celebrate the arrival of the light that shines in lost and broken places,
as we wait for the day when we will live in the fullness of God's kingdom. We light these candles as signs of our shocking hope, our just peace, our fierce joy, the love that transforms us, and Jesus Christ, our wondrous light. May the light burning in our hearts guide us, comfort us, protect us, and tend us in all seasons and circumstances, reminding us that day and night, in the light and in the darkness, God is with us. Our salvation has come. Amen.
Whole month we've had an Advent video series, and we have been looking for signs of hope, peace, joy, and love. So if you watched the virtual service this morning, we included this video as well, but if not, you get to see it brand new. But we are looking for signs of love, and which we find them this evening in the sign of Jesus.
We have reached the end of Advent, and I hope you have enjoyed looking for signs of the season. I hope you have seen signs of hope, peace, and joy, which ultimately point to Christ's love. Love is the culmination of all of these gifts that the Christ child brings upon his arrival. There are signs of love throughout the Nativity story, but we see it ultimately in the birth of Jesus, the gift of Jesus. God became flesh as a gift to us, to join us in our human trials, to give us the love we need to get through them. The mere act of giving himself in this way was out of love. So giving is a sign of love. We give gifts at Christmas time out of love, not obligation, right? One way we have been giving gifts of love this season is through our giving tree. Giving to those who may appreciate a little help is a sign of love, and the act of giving makes us feel love. It feels good to give. This must be what God felt like when God first gave himself to us as Jesus. And that's probably why God continues to give to us. It just feels so good to keep the love going. We might think Christmas wouldn't be Christmas if we didn't give gifts, but many friends and family intentionally say, let's not give gifts this year. It does take a lot out of stress and money out of the holidays, which can actually be a gift. Now, really, when we say let's not give monetary gifts, we're really saying let's give gifts of our time and presence with one another instead. and those are exactly what we receive from the Christ child, the gift of his presence. So look for signs of love this week on Christmas, but also throughout the Christmas season.
Time of worship for our prayer time, our time to pause and be present with Christ, with one another in this moment. And so I invite you during this time, during our centering music and during silent prayer meditation, we have a prayer station over here. If you would like to come over and light a candle, perhaps in memory or in honor of someone, or if you would like to light a candle to mark a special prayer that you are lifting to God, we invite you to do so during this time. You take another moment of silent prayer and meditation. God of light, we come to you on this dark night with open hearts. We desperately want to see and feel your light come into the darkness. I cannot tell you how the light comes. What I know is that it is more ancient than imagining, that it travels across an astounding expanse to reach us, that it loves searching out what is hidden, what is lost, what is forgotten, or in peril or in pain. That it has a fondness for the body, for finding its way toward flesh, for tracing the edges of form, for shining forth through the eye, the hand, the heart. I cannot tell you how the light comes, but that it does, that it will, that it works its way into the deepest dark that enfolds you. Though it may seem long ages in coming or arrive in a shape you did not foresee. And so may we this day turn ourselves toward it. May we lift our faces to let it find us. May we bend our bodies to follow the arc it makes. May we open and open more and open still to the blessed light that comes. Please join with me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our scripture reading tonight is from Luke, Chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over the flocks at night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
We have been walking together through Advent, looking for signs of the season. We began with looking for signs of hope and saw them in the first signs that often signal that Christmas is coming. Christmas trees, nativity, or Advent candles. They are signs of hope because they point to a better time. Christmas, that Christmas, a better time, is coming. Despite the dumpster fire of our lives, the Christ child is coming to bring gifts that sustain us through the flames, the smoke, and the smoldering ash. We looked and listened for signs of peace, signs of baptism and forgiveness, that settle our restless hearts, that calm our fearful hearts, that release guilt or anxiety that often arises within us. We heard these signs through silence, conversations with family and friends, and even in the rup-a-pum-pum of Christmas music. We looked for signs of joy, which meant we often tasted joy and the special foods and flavors that only come out at Christmas. The eggnog, the monkey bread, and the peppermint treats. Those foods and flavors are shared over meals together with family and friends who are family, and they were no less holy than gathering around the communion table. We will taste again how good the Lord is when we take communion together on this holy night. We talked about looking for signs of love this morning during the virtual fourth Sunday of Advent service, but our search for those signs is just beginning. This has been a wonky Advent season. It's always a short, jam-packed 4 weeks, but the calendar seemed to just cram events in on almost every night of the week. This shortened Advent happens every 6 to 7 years, depending on a leap year, but it always takes us by surprise. Usually the weeks of Advent seem to be so clear-cut with the first week of hope, the second week of peace, the third week of joy, and the fourth week of love, and then we kick off the Christmas season with the birth of Jesus. Well, this Advent has seemed discombobulated, focusing on hope while also anticipating the next Sunday of peace, while also preparing ahead for the events during the joy week, trying to work ahead but also stay in the present, but also reflecting on the past. Whew, it was exhausting. Or maybe that was just my Advent. I don't know. Anybody else? Yeah. But isn't that just like our lives? We like to think things are so clear cut and organized and flow smoothly, just like we want them to, or just like we have it planned. But our lives rarely do that. The different areas of our lives get discombobulated and jammed together into one chaotic mess. Plans fail. People get sick. Relationships end. And our loved ones pass away. And we are left holding the pieces of our shattered hearts, trying to make sense out of it, and trying to find a way forward. Within the tangled mess of our lives, there is hope, peace, joy, and love coming to us on this night. These are the gifts the Christ child brings to us when he is born again within us. We have looked for signs of these gifts during the season, and they have all pointed to Jesus being born within us again, so that we can begin again, so we can experience the birth of divine love within us. When we open our hearts to receive these gifts that only Christ can bring, then we have arrived at Christmas. We hold on to hope that our lives and our world won't always be a dumpster fire. We cling to words of peace when it would be so easy to cut someone down with angered words. We intentionally release our sadness and pain to make room for joy that is waiting for us. We love, period. We love like people who haven't been hurt, who aren't bitter or resentful, who aren't skeptical. We love because this is what the Christ child is, a big bundle of love. God joined us in our humanity out of love. God continues to join us in our lives out of love, even when we aren't ready to receive it. Even when we flat out reject it, God is waiting in the wings until we are ready because of love. This love never gives up on us. This love is not pushy. Sometimes we need to learn how bad we need it. This love is not condemning. Sometimes we have to learn the condemnation actually comes from us. This love may seem subtle, and sometimes it takes time to grow. It often takes our whole lives to truly grow into the kind of love that was born this night. The true sign of the season is Jesus. This season is all about Jesus and how he is immersed in every detail. Every song, every decoration, every dessert, every gathering. Even the gatherings that include crosswords or disagreements, Jesus is there, eager to bring healing to the pain that caused them. Jesus is there amidst the difficult conversations. I mean, that's why they are often called coming to Jesus moments. So let us have a coming to Jesus moment this night where we realize and recognize that Jesus has been with us through the whole season. We may not have seen him or felt him, but Jesus has been there the whole time. Jesus is here right now, just waiting for us to open our hearts to receive all that the Christ child brings. Just like the hope he brought to the world on the first Christmas, he continues to bring hope to hopeless situations. Just like on the first Christmas, he continues to bring moments of peace when the world is still and we are in sync with God. Just like on the first Christmas, joy breaks out in a baby's cry, and the world was never the same. Just like on the first Christmas, love could not be contained. It could not be neat and tidy and arrive on schedule. It came at the worst possible time into a messy world because that is exactly what they needed then, and it's exactly what we need now. We need a God who meets us in our caves with smelly animals and gives us a love that cannot be found anywhere else. This love has arrived on this holy night. This love is here for all of us. Let it be born within us, and may our lives be forever changed. Amen. During this time of offering, I invite you to reflect on how you feel called to respond to the word you just received. Maybe you would like to give a special Christmas offering, and so you can do that electronically, or you can place it in the offering box after the service. Maybe you would like to truly give your hearts and lives to God, or to say yes to how God is calling you to serve. During this time of offering, let us offer ourselves to God and receive the gift of Jesus.
Thank you.
Join me in the offering prayer. Holy God, we are grateful for the incredible gift born in a stable in Bethlehem. The love and joy birthed by Jesus has touched and transformed our lives. We bring our gifts to you this night. We bring our gifts of money to continue your mission of peace. We bring our hearts as we adore you and long to follow Jesus. Amen. It is a great honor to participate in Holy Communion together on this holy night. As we remember Mary embracing her new child, we embrace this same child in the bread and the cup. The United Methodist Church practices an open table, so everyone who is here who wants to receive, all ages, can receive the gift of grace. There is nothing more holy than seeing a child reach out for the body of Christ. So if you are worshiping online with us, you may prepare your elements at this time, any bread or wafer and any liquid in a cup will do. When the table is ready, I will invite those who are serving in worship to come first to receive, and then I will invite you to come down the center aisle, and then you can circle back around that way to your seats. You can dispose of the cups in the wastebaskets in the back. If mobility is challenging for you, we can come and serve you at your seat. And we also have gluten-free bread if you prefer it or need it. Just tell me when you come up to receive the bread. Please join me in the liturgy and the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. In the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior, and at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest, and peace to your people on earth." And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. As Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem and there found no room, so Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable, Jesus was born. So by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. And as your word made flesh, born of woman on that night long ago, so on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread. He gave thanks. He broke it. And he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks. He gave it to his disciples and he said, "Drink from it, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for the forgiveness of sin for all people." As often as you take the bread and drink from the cup, do so in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Come, the table is ready. You can come down.
That your baby boy would someday walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you? This child that you delivered soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kissed your little baby, then you kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the prison leave again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy, Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child, the great, the great I am. Thank you.
Please join me in the prayer after communion. We have come to your table of grace. We have seen your glory shown around us. We have heard your peace through sounds of forgiveness. We have tasted the goodness of the Lord. We have embraced this new Christ child within us. May we be the aroma of Christ's offering given to all on this night. Amen. Stand as you are able for our closing hymn for Joy to the World, and this is the time that we will begin moving to the patio, but I will go down the aisle first, and then you can follow me the back.
Joy to the world.
Oh,